He began. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, great was my admiration in listening to the remarks addressed to the youth of Ireland a moment since by my learned friend. It seemed to me that I had been transported into a country far away from this country, into an age remote from this age, that I stood in ancient Egypt, and that I was listening to the speech of a high priest of that land, addressed to the youthful Moses. His listeners held their cigarettes poised to the earth, their smoke ascending in frail stalks that flowered with his speech. Noble words coming. Look out. Could you try your hand at it yourself? And it seemed to me that I heard the voice of that Egyptian high priest raised in a tone of like haughtiness and like pride. I heard his words, and their meaning was revealed to me from the Father. And it was revealed to me that all things are good which yet are corrupted, which neither if they were supremely good nor unless they were good could be corrupted. I crush you, that's the gospel. Why will you Jews not accept our language, our religion, and our culture? You are a tribe of nomad herdsmen. We are a mighty people. You have no cities nor no wealth. Our cities are hives of humanity, and our galleys trireme and quadrireme, laden with all manner merchandise, furrow the waters of the known globe. You have but emerged from primitive conditions. We have a literature, a priesthood, an age-long history, and a polity. Nile, child, man, ethically, by the Nile bank, the babe Mary's kneel, cradle of bulrushes, a man supple in combat, stone-horned, stone-bearded, heart of stone. You pray to a local and obscure idol. Our temples, majestic and mysterious, are the abodes of Isis and Osiris, of Horus and Amun-Ra. Yours, serfdom, awe, and humbleness, ours, thunder and the seas. Israel is weak, and few are her children. Egypt is an host, and terrible are her arms. Vagrants and day laborers are you called. The world trembles at our name. A dumb belch of hunger cleft his speech. He lifted his voice above it boldly. But, ladies and gentlemen, had the youthful Moses listened to and accepted that view of life? Had he bowed his head and bowed his will and bowed his spirit before that arrogant admonition? He would never have led the chosen people out of their house of bondage, nor followed the pillar of the cloud by day. He would never have spoken with the Eternal on Sinai's mountain top, nor ever have come down with the light of inspiration shining in his countenance and bearing in his arms the tables of the law, graven in the language of the outlaw.